What I used was the expression Kanekalon hair in a number 613. I used 3 packs of this. I have this left and I have another one I just put to the side. So I still have 2 bundles left and this is all I have left to do for my hair. So it only took me 3 packs. And what else I used was jam. And I used the flat iron, some gel, one of those edge brushes, a comb, and scissors. So, what I'm gonna do is part my hair. This hair gets everywhere. So this method, the rubber band method, is good for if you like me and you don't have really good grips, and you're not a good braider, this is the best way to go, is to use the rubber band. So I'm gonna put some jam. Then I'm gonna take my edge brush and kind of brush like this. I'm gonna get my rubber band, put my rubber band on. And don't do it too tight, because this is a protective style. We don't need it to be painful or have your scalp bulging. And then plus when you braid it, then you're twisting it, it's already naturally gonna tighten. So you want to do this as loose as you can. And then I'm gonna take my hair. I'm gonna get probably about this much of the hair, and then I'm just gonna wrap it around at the root where the rubber band is, and then start braiding. And then you can take a piece for the third part to put in with your real hair, and then just keep braiding down. Y'all, this is my first time even using this kind of hair. And this is definitely the cheaper route, because I'm usually spending like at least 60 when I use the other brands. Like Marley hair and all that. So then you take another piece. Not too big. Well, I guess it depends on what size you want your dress to be. That depends on how much hair you're gonna take, but mine's was kind of like, they all kind of different size, mediums, large. So what you're gonna do is get the hair, and you can start like from the end parts if you want the top part to be like really thin around the top, or if you want it to be like thick at the roots, then I will start like close to the middle, kind of. So I want mine not too thin, not too thick. So what you do is this piece right here, it lays down, and this piece you're gonna hold between your thumb and your finger. And you really don't have to braid like all the way down, because it don't make a bit of a difference. You're just simply using this as a guide for your dress, the stem part. So I just braid it down to my real hair, which my hair is not that long, so I don't have to go that far. So I just leave it like this. And then get some more hair. About this much. And then start wrapping. I think I'm doing a little bit thicker. A little more hair. Okay. Oh yeah, I'm so excited for this to be my last piece. If you do your own hair, do you know exactly the struggle? You'd be so excited for that last piece to be done. Okay, so I'm just wrapping it down. Make sure that's why I said to kind of widen the hair, because you want to make sure you're covering your real color hair, whatever color that is. Mine's is like a dark brown, so you don't want that showing through. I'm just wrapping. Sometimes the ends get tangled. Alright, make sure to see all of it is covered. It's really hard to look in the camera and do your hair because I'm used to standing in the bathroom mirror and doing my hair. It's really hard to see, but I'll manage. Okay, and keep wrapping down. Remember to push up. See how I pushed up, how much slack that was when I pushed up? So it's basically starting me over again. Because it would have been unraveling if I didn't do that. So I'm going to take a little bit more hair from over here. That's the thickness of it. And I'm just going to keep wrapping downward. Down, down, spiraling down. Up, keep going down. And I didn't do everything the same length. That's why it's called messy fox locks. I didn't want everything perfect the same. I think like if you really want like everything the same length and perfect, you should probably get like the crochet fox locks, because well, I never done that before, but from what I seen on YouTube, they just braid the real hair, attach it to the what is that thing called? The crochet needle, and then pull it through, and then I guess they untwist the hair a little bit and wrap their real hair. I want to thank you guys so much for watching. Please hit like and subscribe to my channel. And remember, you are beautiful.